Welcome to Verse Breakdown. My name is Ewaenruwa Nomaren, and the verse for today is Zechariah chapter 10, verse 11, which reads, "And he shall pass through the sea with affliction, and shall smite the waves in the sea, and all the deeps of the rivers shall dry up. And the pride of Assyria shall be brought down, and the scepter of Egypt shall depart away." Now, this looks like some complicated, packed prophecy, but really it's simple if we just understand the concepts that it's using. So first of all, when it says sea, we should understand it as evil or wickedness, especially since the vision John the Apostle saw in Revelation chapter 21 verse 1 states that there was a new heaven and there was a new earth and there was no more sea. It was talking about how there was no more evil, there was no more wickedness. So this Zechariah chapter 10 verse 11 is talking about how there will be no more evil. He will wipe that away like a sea comes. He will smite it and all of that. As in like he will, there will be a lot of action in the process. And then the last part of the verse is talking about who is involved and how that is going to happen. Now, it uses Egypt and Assyria, and we have to understand what exactly happened to those empires that we will now use to understand what they mean. So, for example, if you look at Exodus chapter 7 to 12, you can see the fall of Egypt. Now, when I say the fall of Egypt, it's not like how, for example, when Assyria fell and it didn't come back in some form. Egypt had continued on, of course, but the way God sort of humbled and humiliated Pharaoh can be, in a sense, considered the fall of Egypt. So in Exodus chapter 7 to 12, God brought 10 plagues, and you can see how it humiliated Pharaoh because it showed him and all those who believed in him that he really had no power. He couldn't do anything. It was, in a sense, God allowing him to do that so that when it's time to humiliate him, his name may be glorified in fulfillment of Exodus chapter 9, verse 16. If you read Exodus chapter 5 and verses 1 and 2, you can see how Pharaoh was proud. He was like, "Who is God that I should obey him or consider him?" But, well, the people that he was freeing, they were rescued, they were able to leave, and Pharaoh himself was humiliated and his army destroyed. Then, if you look at Assyria, they fell in a similar light. When King Sennacherib was in power, they were acting pompous. They were acting as if they were somebody. The way they were taking fortified cities, destroying them, adding it to their lands. They were building and building and building. But eventually, just as how they were sieging Israel, they themselves were sieged by the Babylonian Empire, except this time, that meant they were doomed. Their empire ended, Nineveh was sacked and destroyed and all of that, and that was the end of the empire. People tried to kind of restart it after, but the judgment was laid, and that was the end of it. So it was a sad, humiliating end for a proud empire. And the reason why I've taken the time to explain this is because they help us understand the pride of humanity, specifically the rulers of it. For thousands of years, we've been ruled and controlled by an autocratic, semi-divine system. And that system came from Satan the devil, because he is the god of this world, according to 2 Corinthians chapter 4, and verses 3 and 4. That's why instead of necessarily taking care of humanity, they oppressed it. They acted proud as if they owned the world. And they exercised such leadership. They could do whatever they want. They brought in slavery. They did this. They did that. That humanity has now acknowledged to be bad. But before, they were controlling the world and doing all of that. And in fulfillment of that, Zechariah chapter 10, verse 11, God put all of that to an end by making them fight against one another. If you read Matthew chapter 24, verses 6 and 7, nation rising against nation, kingdom against kingdom, and world wars 1 and 2 brought an end to that system because they were weakened. They fought and they lost their authority and power. And now the leaders that we have are weaker than those. And of course, God is still going to continue on that process until we will live under a system where we will not be oppressed by our leaders. Jesus Christ is going to remove that system in fulfillment of Revelation chapter 19 from verses 15 to 21, so that people who are honored will be those who serve mankind. The idea of oppressing mankind will be seen as bad among all walks of life. And this was summarized in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 13, which reads, "Nevertheless we, according to his promise, look for new heavens and a new earth wherein dwelleth righteousness." And that is where I'm going to stop on discussing that verse, Zechariah chapter 10, verse 11, which once again reads, "And he shall pass through the sea with affliction, and shall smite the waves in the sea, and all the deeps of the river shall dry up. And the pride of Assyria shall be brought down, and the scepter of Egypt shall depart away." If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. God bless you.